Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome now our guest of honor, Professor R.V. Rajakumar, Director, IIT Bhubaneswar. We'd like to request you, please join your hands and let's welcome, sir. We are so glad to have you, sir. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. Professor Ganeshi Lalji, Honorable Governor of Odisha, Sri Vasudev Rao, Dr. Mundraji, Sri Krishanlal Agarwalji, Dr. Sudipta Ghosh, a long-term friend, Professor Edward Jalto, distinguished guests, esteemed participants in this very thought-provoking conference, faculty, staff, and students of IIT Bhubaneswar, members of the media, both print and electronic, ladies and gentlemen, I extend a warm welcome to all of you to our campus. Our institute is a new institute. It is 10 years old, not all that new, but it's 10 years old. But in this campus, we have been here for the last 3 years. We are developing this campus into a wellness environment. I carry on my research in the area of signal processing. In signal processing, we solve engineering problems and provide the solutions in mathematical forms. In the past, when the systems were mostly analog in nature, the solutions were being provided in the form of differential equations and expressed in Laplace transform for convenience. Also, the engineers solve a given problem by mathematically analyzing the problem, because the analysis gives us the behavior of the system. And while solving an engineering problem, what we are interested in is a solution for a physical, real problem in the form of an approximation. If you give to 100 engineers, the 100 engineers may give 100 different solutions. But still, all the solutions would work. They're in the form of approximations. Today, many of the systems, particularly the electronic and computer-related systems, are digital in nature. Therefore, we provide the solutions in the form of difference equations and as a set of rules which are usually expressed in an algorithmic form. We do model a given physical situation and obtain a close mathematical model. And once you get the mathematical model, you are in a position to analyze it. You are in a position to design a system to help in a situation and offer, finally, a solution. Now, if this, the typical real-world problems we are talking about, are expanded further to include other realities like human emotions, and certainly further if we include the element of spirits, then how do we expand the mathematics to model the situation? They're all real. And how these realities can be expressed, and can we have an analytical framework and also finally a solution if there is a problem there? I'm sure all of you agree that The topic of the conference, Mathematics and Reality, is very well thought of. I'm sure it's very highly thought-provoking. And everybody, and rises the interest in every inquisitive mind. I think compliments are due, and let's compliment the Bhaktivedanta Institute for having come up with such a wonderful theme for this conference. I'm sure the conference is going to be a grand success, and all the participants, including myself, would look forward for very thought-provoking presentations during today and tomorrow. Also, I would like to thank Bhaktivedanta Institute for choosing IIT Bhubaneswar as the venue for this conference. The present facility is a community center. We don't have an auditorium yet, but yet we organize outstanding presentations in this conference, and this is one of them. And I would like to profusely thank Bhaktivedanta Institute for having come up with this conference and also for choosing us. And I wish you all the best for today and tomorrow, and have a fruitful time at this venue. Thank you very much.